The Renault Triber has just been launched, and at its global debut, we have with us Laurens van den Akker, the man behind the car in terms of design. Laurens, this must have been one of your toughest projects because here you've got three rows of seating in a sub 4 meter package. So that must have given you sleepless nights.
Yeah, I think, to be honest, when I heard the brief, I thought this is not possible because 4 meters is not very long. It's kind of a bee hatch in Europe. So to fit three rows and seven people in it, and not just small people, but normal people, I thought this was really impossible. So some of the breakthroughs from a packaging perspective are really clever. And one of them is, for instance, that we decided to only do gasoline engines. This gives us an engine compartment that in length is very short, still very wide, but very short. And this allowed us to create a very long wheelbase. Now the long wheelbase, 26, 36 millimeters, is beneficial for multiple reasons. First of all, you create a very big cabin. We need this. Second of all, you create a big second door, which not only allows you to get in and out easily, but also to get access to the third row. And then the short overhangs, big cabin. I think there is 3 meter of cabin space into a 4 meter car. This must be equivalent to what you see in a Mini, the old Mini from Easygonies.
So clearly the long wheelbase was actually a key to, as you said, the packaging and also the rear seat access. Mm. But when you increase the wheelbase, you kind of lose out on torsional stiffness. So how did you kind of compensate for, let's say, keeping the rigidity mm-hmm. of the car?
Yeah, it's very important, like you say, to have a good stiffness of the vehicle of this size, especially with four doors and a hatch. Now, we had one thing helping for us is the width of the car. The car is actually nearly the width of a C segment, of a segment up. This is good for us. It gives a good space for the shoulder room, good wide space for the driver and the passenger, and three people in the second row. And the doors are sash doors, so they're not clamshell doors. That means we have a very strong cantrail going around the cabin compartment, and this makes it secure as well as a very strong and long wheelbase.
And the other thing I wanted to ask you said you have a very short engine bay. In terms of crash, was that a challenge because you do need a fairly wide crumple zone, or what did you do for that? Because to meet the new crash norms, mm-hmm. you would have to have a pretty strong, frontal area.
Yes, that means that the crash length is probably shorter, the crumple zone is probably shorter, but if the engine is smaller, the crash, in fact, is the impact of the engine that slides into the passenger compartment that you need to manage. But with reinforcements on clever areas, the fact that the car is wider, we managed to get around this, and I think we will have good crash results.
Right, and again, I notice 15-inch wheels, which again gives a pretty good stance, but mm-hmm. sometimes that compromises on packaging itself. So just wanted to understand. You would have probably wanted even bigger wheels, but settled for 15. Must have been a fight over there. So just on the wheel size, you've gone up to 15 inches. Mm-hmm. Are you happy with that result?
Yeah, from a design perspective, I would have loved to have 20-inch wheels on the cars, because then you get so much for free. But it's not realistic. In fact, we had to find a really delicate trade-off between comfort also. Smaller wheels and bigger tires is good for the comfort, price, and weight. If the wheels get too big, you slap a lot of weight around. I think 15-inch was in the end a good profile, not just from a side view to give the car a bit of a crossover SUV kind of look, but also from the front. The tire is a little bit wider and it really feels right for the car. A 14-inch wheel and tire would have looked too narrow for the vehicle. So we managed to convince our program team to go with this.
Right, and I think what was quite perceptible is the dashboard quality and the quality of mm-hmm. the plastics, which quite frankly, generally on Renault cars has been one of the weak points, mm-hmm. Quaid, Duster, whatever, just the IP feel hasn't been of high mm-hmm. quality. That seems to have been hugely addressed in this. Was this a focus area for you? I mean, was there a concentrated effort in improving the overall plastic quality and feel?
Yes, absolutely, because I think this has been a great frustration, not only for our clients, but also for myself and my design team. So we worked for more than a year to find, in fact, a grain for the surface of the plastic that is looking very matte and has a very good scratchability, because those are the two things that make up a good quality feeling. you can have a very shiny dashboard, but then with a very good scratchability, but it doesn't look very, it looks very cheap. Or you can have a very matte dashboard, but it scratches very easily. So we worked for more than a year to find just the right amount of grain and this was the secret, a micro mapping, a second micro grain on top of the first grain that gives us just the right balance. And I think if you look now inside the interior, you might even fool yourself and think the interior is painted.
And can we see this technology or this process now on other Renault products?
Yes, absolutely, because we found the holy grail of grains. We found the holy grain, if
and,
you will.
And on a budget car like
this. And on a budget car, so we are now able to apply it across the board, absolutely.
And last question, Lawrence, point of conflict, maximum point of conflict, is it always the third row vis-a-vis height, vis-a-vis space? You know, that's the thing. You want the vertical space, but you don't
Correct.
Want it to look vertical. Was that the point of maximum conflict in this car?
Yes, I think if you go from the front to the back of the car, the tension was really finding its summit right at around the heads of the third row.
Is that because of the hinges of the...
Yeah, because there's multiple issues. You have the hatch with the hinges that need a lot of strength. You don't want these hinges to sit right on top of your head. Vertical headroom in the third row is very important because you're sitting on top of the rear axle. So if you bounce around, you will be the one to suffer most. So we did a couple of things. We put a bump in the roof, which you cannot actually see because we hit the bump with a roof rack that gives it the baroudeur look. We did a second thing where we made the pillars look very fast, while the window is actually quite upright, but you don't notice it because you're always looking more at the body color than at the real window. And we created a theater seating so that if you're in the second row, in the third row, you're always sitting a little bit higher, and this allows you for a perfect visibility versus the front. But I can tell you, we must have redone this area 500 times.
Well, I think it's been worth the effort because really in terms of packaging, in terms of space efficiency, the Triber sitting in under 4 meters definitely is a new benchmark. Congratulations.
Thank you very
and
much.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you.